can't put any more people over here. How's the weather out there?
It's not bad.
Really? Yep.
Welcome, everybody. My name is Ed Schlesinger. I'm the Benjamin T. Rome Dean of the Whiting School of Engineering, and I'd like to welcome you all here today. First off, congratulations to all our graduates. I know that today represents the culmination of a lot of hard work, and we're all proud of your accomplishments. You leave here possessing the knowledge to effect positive change in the world and with the ability to help shape our future. And I'm not alone in recognizing in the important role that you as engineers have to play in the future of our country and our world. Over the past 2 years, I know that the Whiting School celebrated the centennial of engineering at Johns Hopkins University. I think that these sorts of occasions can provide institutions with a great sense of context. They offer opportunities for reflection on accomplishments and on the enormous changes that have occurred since our founding. But perhaps more importantly, these occasions provide the opportunity to look ahead as well. When Johns Hopkins Department of Engineering opened in the fall of 1913, the school enrolled 98 undergraduates and 14 graduate students, and in the first years offered courses in three disciplines, electrical, mechanical, and civil engineering. At that time, it was acknowledged that engineers would be critical to address the technological challenges that lay ahead. Johns Hopkins understood that the future of such critical areas in communication, transportation, energy, for example, would rely on contributions of engineers. And wisely, the university has enabled the founding of a school of engineering. But even with their foresight, they probably couldn't imagine the social, political, health, and economic challenges that were looming, some just around the corner. 1913, for those of you who are interested in such matters, was the year that the permanent federal income tax was introduced. To those of you who really care about such things, the rate was 1% on incomes over $4,000, or about $94,000 in today's currency, on a federal budget of about $715 million, or about $17 billion in today's dollars. With numbers like that, I think that we would not be talking about federal budgets, taxes, or the IRS if we had stayed on that course. But to give you some idea of what things really looked like back in 1913, life expectancy in the United States for those born in 1913 was about 50 years for men and 55 for women. The population of the world was about 1.6 billion, with the population of the US around 95 million. The Wright brothers had demonstrated heavier than air flight only about a decade earlier. And the United States produced some 485,000, or about 80% of the world total of 606,000 motor vehicles. And only 5 years earlier, the Model T had been introduced into the market. In the United States, the leading cause of death was tuberculosis, which claimed about 94,000 people. Cancer was number two, and diarrhea claimed 50,000 as number three. Diseases such as diphtheria and croup, typhoid, measles, scarlet fever, and whooping cough were other leading causes of death, claiming over 40,000 lives combined. The telephone, invented in the previous century, now saw about 9 million phones in service, or only about 1 per 10 people in the US. Little did anyone in 1913 suspect that they were going to head into the roaring 20s, the crash of 29, the depression of the 1930s, prohibition, World War I, and the pandemic of 1918. The world would be plunged again into the darkness of World War II, the Holocaust, the development and use of the atomic bomb, the end of the British Empire, the start of the Cold War and the Korean War, and all this before the century was half over. But that century would also see great advances. The first commercial radio broadcast in 1920, the discovery of insulin, and the conquest of diseases such as polio. Air travel moved from the pioneer era of aircraft made of wood and fabric to the golden age of aircraft development, with planes becoming high-powered monoplanes made of aluminum and able to carry many passengers. The 707 was demonstrated in flight in 1954, and the launch of Sputnik was in 1957. While expensive at the time, we would see the introduction of television, including color TV, and the first color TV broadcast in the US in 1954 from the Tournament of Roses parade. And then there was a demonstration of the transistor in 1947 by John Bardeen and Walter Brattain at Bell Labs. Today, I look at you as we in the Whiting School embark on the second century of engineering at Johns Hopkins. And I realize that just like our founders did 100 years ago, we can plan for the future, but we cannot know what changes will lie ahead. Some of the statistics that I noted for 1913 when put in today's context have really improved. Life expectancy for those born today in the United States is about 76 years for men and 81 for women. The population of the world is now 7 billion, and that of the U.S. about 316 million. The world now produces about 85 million motor cars annually, with about only 10% produced in the U.S. And in the United States, leading causes of death are heart disease, cancer, still number two, respiratory disease, and stroke, followed by accidents above those deaths due to Alzheimer's disease and diabetes. And the number of cell phones in the United States, let alone phones, is greater than the U.S. population. And once feared diseases are now simple childhood ailments due to the development and use of vaccines. But we also continue to face many challenges around the world. According to UNICEF, 19,000 children under the age of 5 die each day due to preventable causes. According to the World Bank, 1.2 billion people today are still without access to electricity and all the benefits that brings in terms of health, education, and well-being. At the same time today, we see humanity achieving amazing feats of intellectual accomplishment in science, engineering, and the arts. The existence of the Higgs boson was confirmed, allowing humans to confirm a model for the very nature of the building blocks of the universe. And we have seen technology and communication inspire revolutions and help bring freedoms to millions. And just as so much was accomplished for good in the first century of the Whiting School, even more could be accomplished for good in this second century. What will that future hold for you? What are the historical events that you will live through? What will you be witness to? And what challenges will be placed before you? Of course, none of us know. What we do know, and I think that this is very important, that as graduates of an elite university, and as such, you have been blessed with a privilege, an opportunity, and a responsibility that a very small percentage of people have been given. You have been given the privilege of an outstanding education and the benefits it brings in one of the most important fields today, engineering. Developments in computation and communication and all the associated information technologies that would truly appear to be science fiction to those who founded our school in 1913 are at your disposal. Your ability to move across boundaries, both geographical and intellectual, provides you with opportunities and resources to address the world's most pressing issues in a manner never before possible and certainly not available in 1913. You have the resources to tackle issues of human well-being and security, health, energy, the environment, and sustainability, disease, economic development, and poverty, and more. In many ways, I believe that you, as engineers, are the most well-equipped graduates of any field to address these most important challenges. You have the potential to achieve great things, and more importantly, you have the opportunity, the ability, the resources, and I have to emphasize this, the responsibility to meet the challenges we all face to make the world a better place. We have tremendous confidence in you and what you can do, and we look forward to seeing all you will achieve for good in our second century. Your knowledge and skills, your inventiveness and imagination will help build new industries and solve some of the toughest problems our world faces today. And that, as a graduate of Johns Hopkins, you have the ability to change the world, to make discoveries, to improve people's lives. And while graduation is a huge achievement, it is just the beginning of what you will do. And that's why this is called a commencement. And today you join our ranks as alums. You will always be connected to this institution. And from what I've seen professionally throughout my career and during my time at the Whiting School, this is an impressive group, made more impressive today by the addition of all of you, the members of the class of 2014. Congratulations once again. the Applied Physics Lab, a very important part of Johns Hopkins University. Congratulations. We at the Applied Physics Laboratory are proud of our partnership with the Whiting School of Engineering towards the education of many of you who are graduating this evening. Now, one might say that we engineers literally shape the future through our technology, and sometimes with dramatic results. So I would like to take a couple minutes to explore the future that you might design for us. Now, there is some risk of this, as some future predictions of the 1950s and 60s would come true, we would be talking on our picture phones to our relatives living on Mars while riding in our self-driving nuclear-powered vehicles. But some things are correctly predicted. We do have picture phones, for example, through Skype, and we hear that self-driving cars are on the way. So here are some possibilities. Will you perfect brain versus machine interactions that will bring us computer-assisted mental telepathy? One of our partners in DARPA's Revolutionizing Prosthetics program was recently featured on 60 Minutes, feeding herself a chocolate bar with the Johns Hopkins prosthetic arm just by thinking about it. Perhaps we'll design the fabrication of food from organic materials, such as the beef hamburger recently grown entirely in a laboratory in the Netherlands, but so far it's set a cost of several hundred thousand dollars per burger.
Oh, no.
But this does begin to approach the Star Trek food synthesizer. Will you engineer a way to reduce the impacts of global climate change? Or if climate impacts are not reduced globally, will you design structures to lessen the effects of severe storms and droughts in the local regions? Perhaps the domed cities of the old science fiction movies would be an option. And finally, you might design equipment to mine and transport minerals from asteroids and reduce the environmental impacts of mining on Earth. Or maybe you will invent affordable technologies that finally allow us to colonize Mars. And perhaps you will also help us better understand why we might want to colonize Mars. As Johns Hopkins graduates, we have the educational foundation to lead us into the future. As the Whiting School and APO researchers address the global challenges and opportunities, you may even decide to remain engaged and collaborate with us, and we would welcome that.
Oh, sure.
So as the technical architects of our future, I congratulate you and wish you every success. Thank you, Jerry. It is now my great pleasure to introduce today's keynote speaker, Dr. Michael J. Zinner. You'll find his complete bio in your programs, but let me just say a few words by way of introduction. Dr. Zinner is the Mosley Professor of Surgery at Harvard Medical School and the Surgeon-in-Chief at the Brigham and Women's Hospital and the Clinical Director of the Dana-Farber Brigham and Women's Cancer Center. He received his bachelor's degree in electrical engineering in 1967 from Johns Hopkins and his medical degree from the University of Florida School of Medicine in 1971. He is a member of the editorial boards of several surgical journals and has been on the board of several hospitals and healthcare systems around the country. Dr. Zinner was past president of the Association for Academic Surgery, past president of the Society of the University Surgeons, and past president of the Society of Surgical Chairmen, among many other distinctions. In 2004, he established the Center for Surgery and Public Health, a collaboration between the Harvard Medical School and the Harvard School of Public Health, focused on healthcare, quality, safety, and effectiveness, and global surgical care. The CSPH has mentored many national prominent surgeons into important positions all over the globe. In 2007, he was awarded the Johns Hopkins Distinguished Alumnus Award, and in 2010, he was inducted into the Johns Hopkins Society of Scholars, both for his illustrious professional achievements. For the past 4 years, he has taught courses on healthcare at the Heller School for Social Policy and Management at Brandeis University, and was recently appointed adjunct professor there. It is truly my pleasure to welcome Dr. Zinner to the podium.
Thank you, Dean. I am deeply honored to be able to give this address. And when Dean Schlesinger originally contacted me earlier this year about giving the address, I said, are you sure you have the right guy? Because if you look back over my record as an undergraduate, you wouldn't be asking me this question, and you wouldn't be asking me to give this address. He said, no, let's go ahead and let's go ahead with that. So I'm going to tell you my story. So graduates and proud parents and family, let me tell you where I came from. I was born, grew up in Miami, Florida, went to a large public high school where there were over 900 students just in my graduating class. I was a quintessential geek at the time. You know, National Honor Society, then the Westinghouse Science Talent Search, now the Intel Science Talent Search. I had built a digital computer at the age of 16 and won a science fair project. I built the computer out of old pinball machine parts because one of my best friend's father was in the amusement park business. I was able to win some competitions, and I never left Florida until I was 18 years old when I applied for and got into the Wharton School of Engineering. There were some interesting recollections that I have in my first year of a traumatic transition from a large public high school in the South and Hopkins. I was shocked to learn, for example, that many of my classmates had already used the same textbooks in high school that I was looking at for the first time, like Professor Andrews in the Fundamentals of Chemistry, two professors from Hopkins. So they were doing great. They were having no problem at all passing the test because they've already had that course in high school. I, of course, was struggling through that. And when they would say, let's go out for a social event, I'd say, well, they look like they're doing pretty well. I guess I'll go out with them, only to get killed, absolutely killed in grades. And then I did some other pretty stupid things as an undergraduate. I was a very straight, narrow, scholarly individual in high school. And when I got to Hopkins, there were other things that interested me, actually fascinated me. For example, I signed up to be a radio announcer at the campus radio station, WJHU. And if you recall that era, this is now fall of 1993, it was when President Kennedy was assassinated, November 19, 1963. I was at the news desk, and the news obviously began to explode through the news desk. And I had, my job was to report what was going on. Challenging, difficult time, great sorrow followed after that. And again, it took me way from my academic courses and my grades again to learn to suffer. I took a shot at language, particularly German. And well, that just didn't go very well either. I failed German the first year. I think you're beginning to get the picture. Okay, with renewed enthusiasm, I started the second year in engineering. Now, I was able to observe interesting engineering problems. One of my most favorite courses, and also horrifying courses, is something called Measurement Experimentation, MEU, also known to us as Visiting and Exclusion Engineering. It was taught by Professors Palmer and Palm, and one experiment I vividly remember was we were given a box, and there was a surface inside that box. We were given a drill and some dowels to put through the top and measure the distance from the top of the box down to the surface, and we had to arrive at the equation of the surface through differential equations. Well, it was a killer experiment. It still would be better. So we had to take my mind off the drudgery of these simultaneous equations. I made another mistake. I got involved in apples. That's with the Barnstormers here in the old barn. For those who are not up yet, that's the playhouse. The play I most remember is a play called The Fantastic. So for me, it was fantastic. We had a successful run. We extended the run. did studies kind of suffer a little bit from this. I didn't have a major role, I had a minor role as a sidekick, but I so got into it that my studies just completely collapsed. Well, I think you see where this is headed. Combination of radio station, theatrics, social life, great uncle. After failing first year journalism again in the second year, I knew I was going to have to take it a third time, so I thought maybe I'm going to major in first year journalism. Mercifully, my father, who was paying the tuition, ended my misery after the second year and pulled me out of college. I had 15 B credits in the second semester of my second year. He had to go to the University of Miami. He was a professor at the University of Miami. And I was a local kid, so we got a tuition break. And again, he kept telling people I was spending my junior year abroad at the University of Miami. I was actually there at Carl Gettles taking things like organic chemistry. And again, it's interesting to me what I recall for this topic. What I recall from organic chemistry, not much, but Miami is hot and there are open breezeways outside of each laboratory. So we were given absolute ethanol. This is not denatured ethanol, absolute ethanol. There was always a propaganda juice machine right outside the laboratory. So we were able to strip through the afternoon with some speed bottles mixing the alcohol and the oranges. So why am I telling you these tales of juvenile rebellion and foolishness? There's a punchline I promise. Anyway, I was able to come back to Hopkins my senior year, and to my great fortune, I met a junior professor at Lecture Hall named Stephen Moore. Just as an aside, Stephen Moore would leave Hopkins after 10 years, join the National Science Foundation, and later go on to be one of the developers of the internet. Not outdoors, but the real developer of the internet. He was the director of networking at the National Science Foundation, developed NSF.net. This was the first open computing network in the United States in 1985. The rest of the story is all about Professor Wolfis and the rest of his life. He proved to be a spectacular teacher, a wonderful mentor, and inspired me to do a senior thesis looking at defined stochastic processes as they were applied to AI targeting. It was a computerized model that required hundreds of hours of programming in Fortran, language that we remember that we were, and punch cards. Unfortunately, we don't have to do that anymore either. The computer that we were using was an old IBM 790 series. It was typically on campus, sitting at AL in Hagerstown, and we would communicate through places in the library. Now, since no undergraduates were allowed to use the computer during the day, I basically had to bribe the computer operators at night with pizzas and hoagies to be able to get time on the machine that I'd never seen what it worked on. And for some of you who are not engineers, you cannot imagine the era where computer memory was made out of a ring of iron material that would form binary numbers by magnetizing in one direction for one and the opposite direction for zero, which is where the term core has since come. We are coming at the stone age of the world of computing. I support my results regularly to Professor Wolf, and he ignited my inquisitive side, my interest, and my dedication to hard work. He taught me linear thinking, problem solving, and running lines of computer code on punch cards absolutely taught me precision and discipline. Those hard-fought nights, punching out computer cards, made me understand what small errors like a misplaced period or an uncompensated comma or parenthesis could be like. Now that discipline today carries into my current life. That kind of reading allows me to be on the editorial board of four of my professional journals, and I am also an author of my part of the profession, the best-selling worldwide professor. All of that came from my experience here. So, to finish my story, I went on to medical school. I used my computer and signal processing background to study electroretinograms of the eye. I then went on to become a surgeon in training. I was chairman of surgery at the University of California, Los Angeles for 6 years. And now the chairman of the Department of Surgery at Harvard for 20 years. I supervise over 100 residents, 120 faculty, 350 employees, and a budget of close to $100 million a year. I also serve as the clinical director of the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute, and I introduced mobile disciplinary care to cancer patients 15 years ago. Thank you. So, introducing multidisciplinary care, I learned that cancer care is much like good science. It's a team effort. And with my colleagues at my institution, we're able to establish a large operating room that has multiple imaging, so that we have an MRI at one end and a PET CT scan at the other, and the middle is an operating room with characteristics like a cat lab. What Hopkins experience did for me was that it taught me what a permissive culture can do. That is, it permitted me to fail, but permitted me to succeed also. I was given a set of tools I did not realize I had. These tools were the ability to think critically, the ability to solve problems, the ability to be a linear thinker, and most importantly, the ability to fail and then recover. So to all the parents out there that graduate, success will never be a straight line. Remember mentorship, and now when I'm asked, I tell people I'm the young people who do this. And that is how I hope to be remembered in my own institution. I learned that all from you. Don't be afraid to fail, but do be afraid not to try or not to take risks. So, thank you for the opportunity. And to conclude and paraphrase Michael Bloomberg, former mayor of New York, engineering undergraduate 3 years ahead of me, I am the reason there is a top 50% first part of the class at engineering school. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you, Dr. Zinner, for your address to the class of 2014. I am Ed Scheinman, the Vice Dean for Education, and here we go. It's hard to hear up here, so I know you everyone wants to hear their sons, daughters, husbands, wives, fathers, mothers' names read, so please. We now begin with the degree ceremony. We will present the hoods for all doctors and philosophy candidates. The hooding will be done by each student's advisor or other faculty representative. The actual awarding of these diplomas will take place at tomorrow's commencement ceremony. I would ask all participants or faculty and departments to come forward so as I call the name of their department, and the candidates will join me near the podium, and then we'll cross the stage, such as it is, and shake hands with the dean. We will now begin with the field of applied mathematics and statistics. Sandra Adali will be hooded by Dan David. Thank you.
Wei Chang Chen will be hooded by any words.
She can move over like a foot to the left. I don't know if she can. She's the official photographer.
Tara Joy Edwards will be hooded by Mike Bennett.
Next, Joseph Ayo Akinyele will be appointed by Avi Rubin. Douglas Carlson will be appointed by Avi Rubin. Scott Gilotti will be appointed by Aaron Jensen.
I think it's my Wi-Fi.
Kailash Patil will be hooded by Munya Abdullahi. gift will be hooded by Howard Katz. And next will be the field of mechanical engineering. Putnam Bai will be hooded by Charles Medeva. And that completes the hoodie. the awarding of the Hood PhD Awards. We will now proceed. And we now proceed to the awarding of master's degrees and certificates. I am Dan Horn, the Assistant Dean for Engineering for Professionals within the Whiting School of Engineering. Those of you who completed your requirements for graduation last summer and last fall have already received your diplomas in the mail. Those of you who completed your graduation requirements this spring may pick up your diplomas here in the gym during the reception after the ceremony. As you cross the stage tonight, you will be shaking hands with your department representative and holding a diploma look-alike for pictures. After shaking hands, all graduates are requested to return back upstairs around the track. We will now proceed with the awarding of the master's degrees. With Dr. Eileen Haas, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Applied Biomedical Engineering. Scott David Simpkins. Alan Zane. With Dr. James Spall, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Applied and Computational Mathematics. James F. Capo. Matthew James Davis. Erica Estevez. Daniel Aaron Lipson. Clinton Monk. Laura Taylor Nelson. Robert Conan St. Pierre. Sean Stern. Ashlyn M. Winkler. Lauren Ashley Withrow. With Dr. Daniel Naiman, Department Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Arts in the field of Applied Mathematics and Statistics. Sierra Marie Costanza. Alexander Lawrence Cropper. Weidong Han. Minsoo Hong. Nan Huang. Theodore Jonathan Huang. Jing Liu. Theodoros Spiridon Manolatos. Robert Aaron Nathanson. Ava Pengwei. Jordan Pryor. Liu Tan. Brian Michael Ward. Yanni Zhang. Those with a Master's of Science in Engineering in the field of Applied Mathematics and Statistics. With Dr. Harry Charles, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Applied Physics. Stephanie Mann Ferrone. Patrick Kelly Moneyhunt. Dr. Elliot McVeigh, Chair, Department of Biomedical Engineering. Please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Bioengineering, Innovation, and Design. Eric David Ashukian. Joshua Budman. Kevin James Colbert. Melissa Iger Diskin. Aaron Christopher Enton. Jennifer Gilbertson. Kevin Patrick Keenahan. Yon Lee. Julia Hannah Michaelo. Michael Vincent Parlato. Prateek Patel. Matthew John Petney. Ashley Paul Hemus. Pongti Shaw. Anand Vijayanathan Subramanian. Tiffany Sang. Brock Taylor Weberman. Barrett Jefferson Yates. Dr. McVeigh, Department Chair, please remain for the handing out of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Biomedical Engineering. Vatsal Agarwal. Pornpat Atamanwar. Musa Jahadi. Dina W. Jamal. Shumyo Majumdar. Piyush Patdar. Vikram Aditya Raja. Sandhya Ramesh. Agam Shailesh Shah. Suhyun Shin. Steven Hancock Su. Thailand Huang Thailand Trin. Martine Villarino. Mary Zhang. With Dr. Constantinos Constantopoulos, department chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Masters in the field of chemical and biomolecular engineering. Olawasien Malapo Olaimola. Dr. Constantopoulos, please remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of chemical and biomolecular engineering. Nicholas A. Barbera. Randy E. Bell. Yachin Cao. William Cahoon. Leo Yang. Chiyu Tong Fu. Mike Horn. Yuan Xiao Billy Wang.
Even the phone is trying.
Claudia Danilia Reyes. Harrison Joseph Schwartz. Amelia Christina Vianilla. Christopher Michael Woodson. Jechang Young. Jilin Zhang. With Dr. Rachel Sangri, Program Chair. Please come forward for the awarding of the Masters in the field of Civil Engineering. Kathleen Berry. Ian Andrew Cousins. Stephen S. Wong. Andrew Mahendra Law. Nathan Paul McConaughey. Jeff Walkley. Dr. Sangri, please remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Civil Engineering. Matthew R. Dove. Richard Joseph Irv. Andrew Gaynor. Alexander David Horn. Erin Elizabeth Crew. Michael Vincent DeJoy. Jin Yi Ben. Anne Claire Monagall. Taylor Woodrum. Danji Zhao. Mu Zhu. With Dr. Thomas Longstaff, Program Chair. Please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of computer science.
Emmanuel Chong Egao. Castiel Alejandro Chavez. Jeffrey Michael Goldman. Andrew C. Heimbach. Zanmin Wong. Steve E. Hudson III. Lee Tajo Huff. Sudhakar Reddy Kanchi. Ryan Thomas Kemp. Danny Lee. Susan Maisier Nguyen. Joseph Sumi Monsalo. Crystal McKinney. Ryan Jean Menegui. Payam Meyer. Benjamin Lewis Morlock. Juan Nguyen. Vanessa Marie Nyepelt. Alexander Nolly. Matthew Palin. Ben Pat. Clint Pitzak. Stuart Pulliam. Dustin T. Rodriguez. Benjamin Raymond Salazar. Shireen Shafiq. Patrick Driscoll Sharkey. Andrew Martin South. Michael Anthony Silk. Gursabak Gary Seaman. Nitin Singhal. Donna Smith. Nathaniel Abel Solomon. Amy Marie Stanley. Jason Paul Swallows. John Tanney. Dustin William John Dorso. With Dr. Otto Rubin, professors, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of computer science. Lakshmisha Nandakur Bhatt. Shaji Chen. Renyuan Cheng. Shenhong Jiang. Chua Chu. Jingyi Deng. Daniel Deutsch. James J. Doberspike. Aiden Fowler.
Thank you. Are you
done? Jackie Gao.
Oh.
Yifan Gay. Yush Kong. Chihong Ho. Jun Ki Hong.
I made it this far.
Yao Huang. Ashish Kumar. Sharon Peng Lee. Peng Huang Lu. Vaibhav Mohan. Sung Ni. Piyush Rautra. Dongyi Shen. Ayushi Sinha. Zhao Huan Tian. Shuai Tong. Cheng Shuan Zai. David Eric Wyden. Zhaobei Wu. Juemin Yang. Xi Zhang. With Dr. Brian Jennison, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Derek Alley. Andre J. Bamu. Timothy Harbitsky. Nishi Sandeep Bhagat. Christine Chan. Angel Dagoberto Diaz Ortiz. Bradley Green. Justin Herrick Horst. Jesse William Holsizer. Arlithia Carianis. Saman Holdeban. Gregory Thomas Krause. Mikhail Alexander Moe. Sarah Turner Morimoto.
David Dustin Nichols. How Pan. Daniel Parsons. Nariman Poramati. Robert John Reyes. Michael Schrouder. Sa'i Sabali. Sarah Stiles. Gregory Allen Talaly. Harris Dykeer. Sarah Yang. With Dr. Jin Yang, Department Chair, please come forward for the awarding of a Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Heyoung Cao. Dunhuan Chen. Kun Chen. Zhengwei Cheng. Daniel Gore Delaney. Richard James Stevens. Zhao Gao. Noah Lampo Greenbaum. Vladislav Jerebek. Tao Lee. Shopping Lee. Lee Jay Dong. Singwoo Leo. Tianjin Shen. Shuli Xi. Gunnar Adley Sigurdsson. Yizu Tian. Zhou Wen Jing. Tao Jiang. Menchen Su. Wei Wei. Joseph Zabadny. Bijun Zhang. Chen Zhao. Nina Zhao. Hao Zhu. Zhu. With Dr. Pamela Sheff, Center for Leadership Education, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Engineering Management. Lindsay Cadham. Monty Aurora. Xijiang Chen. Carolyn Miller. Nicholas Earl Flower. Alex Hernandez. Catherine Rose Howard. Karat Shruti Jayachandran. Jason Guy Cool Lansdowne. Wen Liu. Rahul Moody. Inzer Nee. Alexa Oxen. Aniket Anit Puri. Joseph Samuel Saltzman. Ada Alicia Sierra. With Dr. Hedy Alavi, Program Chair, please come forward for awarding the Masters in the Field of Environmental Engineering. Harold Hervé Z. Itama. Dr. Alavi, please remain for awarding the Master of Science in the Field of Environmental Engineering and Science. Jamie Elizabeth Bell. Adrian Earl Brown. Stephanie Long. Dr. Alavi, please remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in the Field of Environmental Planning and Management. Michael Friedman. Kurt Brand. Reza Atami. Megan Rebecca Classic. Adam Scott Mazlowski. Lindsay A. McCanty. Michael Ryan Morgan. Jennifer Vijaythanga. Andrew Christopher Nguyen. With Dr. Daniel Lehman, Department Chair of Applied Mathematics and Statistics, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the Field of Financial Mathematics. Young Bai. Nguyen Gao. Nicholas Michael Moussakis. Wenjang Wang. Yajing Wang. then in the game. Would Dr. Edward Bauer, department chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Arts in the field of geography and environmental engineering. Christopher Ryan Cruz. Wei-Wei Zhang. Dr. Bauer will remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Geography and Environmental Engineering. Anna Ahmed. Tao Li. Wang Mengshu. Zhehui Xia. Jinyu Zhang. Dr. Bauer will remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Geography and Environmental Engineering. Wenzhou Bai. Yuan Cheng. Jonathan Lewis Ho. Jason Huang. Hong Chen Yu. Julianne Benson Peng. Duke Kong Fong. Yu Qian. Nate Zhang. Would Dr. Thomas Longstaff, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the Field of Information Assurance. Kai Ming Chen. Zachary Whittington. Dr. Longstaff will remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Information Systems Engineering. Max Allen Kerber. Philip Ryan Dasher. Andre Davis. Nathaniel Kibede Gebremarian. Kevin Johnson. Shailen Joy. Brandon Lichtenwalder. Jonathan Lorraine. Andrew Neville. Kamal Ranabat. Sandra Rivera. With Dr. Howard Katz, Department Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Materials Science and Engineering. Wenmin Guo. Xiao Wan. Benjamin David Lawson.
Austin Taylor Thomas Young. Dr. Robert Camerata, Program Chair, please come forward to be awarding the Master's in the Field of Materials Science and Engineering. Melissa Lynn Jones. Min Hoang Bo. Would Dr. Lewis Whitcomb, Department Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master's in the Field of Mechanical Engineering. Benjamin P. Alvarez. Michael Peter Dixon. Christopher M. Henley. Brian Nicholas Lounsbury. Dr. Whitcomb will remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of Mechanical Engineering. Matthew Paul Addis. Michael Reza Cameron Amal. Thomas Michael Ayoff. William Morris Crawford. Keelan Crockett Crow. Sarah Rose Dodge. Anirban Ghosh. Andreas Hugo. Andrew Graff Kelly. Rishu Purana. Derek Chandler Cooper. Xiao Li. Kevin Douglas Parsons. Kristen Sparrow. Allison Tiffany Say. Gianna Wong. Chinglin Zhao. With Dr. Anton DeBura, Program Chair of the Information Security Institute, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the Field of Security Informatics. Diva Asmat. William Joseph Burke. Jeremy Corey. Balaji Damodar Swami. Joel Robert Bailey. Anupriya Datta. Neil Allen Eikenberry. Francis Takriki Hanania. Giovanni Manuel Hernandez. Jiwen Wang. Yuji Wang. Lalit Jagorta. Yashmir Kosraju. Kay Lee. Anupam Mehta. Bakul Singhal. Tiani Yang. Manjao Yu. With Dr. Ronald Lumen, Program Chair, please come forward for the awarding of the Master of Science in the field of Systems Engineering. Scott Francis Abney. Amy Dutro Beckman. Thomas P. Bowens. Sheetal Ashok Brahmat. Sherry Sinali. Richard J. Chingabrana Jr. Frederico Mendoza Dancer. Peter F. Dooley. Jessica Lee Faust. Paul G. Langstrom. John Pendleton Gaines. Steve Herman Gerringer. Karensa T. Gordon. Stephanie Saima Guzman. Dwayne Edward Harris. Timothy Joseph Keith. John Allen Henke. Sonny Javed. Jennifer Murphy Johnson. Nori Robin Laszlo. Fanny Lee Bennett. Charles Michael Marakis. Ethan Lowe. Peter John Moxis. Jeffrey Paul Martinez. Patrick Miner. John Mulvihill. Wilson Narvaez. Yaman Chan. Eric Stephen Phelps. Diana Raz. Victoria Lee Rios. Alexander Turgan Ruiz. Kevin Brian Santini. Gregory Michael Teal. Bradley Towery. Michael Wallhopter. Gregory Mark Williams. Ellen Winrow. Dr. Lumen will remain for the awarding of the Master of Science in Engineering in the field of systems engineering. Savannah Andu. Dimitri Bang. Christopher Thomas Bates. Catherine Jean Bellavo. Wayne H. Berry. Frank Benjamin Young. Michael Boruto. Adam T. Brill. John Paul Calvo. Ronald Campbell. Melissa Suzette Cordova. Carla DeCastro. Darnell Derek Eaton. Andrew Seth Fleischman. Margaret Michelle Frazier. Trenton Cole. Timothy Donald Getzy. Carrie Crystalin is Wesley. Rolando Herrera. Joe Musan Inti. Casey Nicole John. Jay Kim. Taylor Littlehead. Ayu Martinez.
Jeffrey Manning.
Kelvin Oladina. Seth Joseph Miller. Rachel Lauren Glasgow. Laura on Chester. Edwin Meyer Strong III. Ben Williams. And Dr. Harry Shaw, please come forward for the awarding of the Poison Master Certificate in the field of applied physics.
Oh, this is the last time. It looks like.
Sunday Adebayo Nipalayi. That completes the awarding of degrees and certificates. And now I would like to invite Ms. Jacqueline M. Akapulu to speak on behalf of the Society of Engineering Alumni.
I did, but I didn't do it.
challenge of another day. Thank you.
Stick around and get one more, they'll mail it to you.